Thousands of people have their power back on tonight. We Energy says strong winds left close to 15,000 customers in the dark last night.
WeatherWatch 12 News' Lyra O'Brien has some of the worst damage and talks to those who enjoyed an extra day off because of it.
It's not the typical sound you'd expect to hear inside Whitefish Bay Middle School on a school day, but the alarm is letting you know something is wrong. It first started going off at 2 a.m., and when groundskeepers arrived before 7, they called school officials to alert them the power was off.
Thought initially it'd be about an hour, hour and a half, and that makes it a little hard because you're not sure what to do if it's going to be that short of time. Do we bring the kids in? Do we take them over to high school? But about 20 minutes later, we learned that it was going to be at least maybe 5 or 6 o'clock at night before they could get the power back on.
Officials then made the call to cancel class and close the building for the day. Many of the kids said they found out about the day off while on their way to school.
And I thought at first it was a prank because, like, so we would be late, but then, like, everybody started riding back, so there's no school. Yay.
I feel happy. It's a relief, as I would say.
Tonawanda Elementary School in Elm Grove also closed its doors because of a lack of power. Tuesday night, strong winds gusting at times over 50 miles per hour knocked out power lines and cut tree branches. In West Bend, home video shows how a fallen limb started an electrical fire. To get everything back up and running, We Energy says it has extra crews running across the area, making sure homes, businesses, and schools will have the power they need to get back into their routine. In Whitefish Bay, Lyra O'Brien, WISN 12 News.
And We Energies is reporting that about 400 people are still without power at this hour. Most of those outages are in the Metro Milwaukee area.